Holy Eucharist begins on the page that is numbered 1. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Your righteousness, Lord, is like the strong mountains, and your justice as the great deep. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
With you is the well of life, and in your light we see light. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Oh, continue your righteous dealing to those who are true of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son came into the world that he might destroy the works of the devil and make us children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant that having this hope, we may purify ourselves as he is pure, that when he comes again with power and great glory, we may be made like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do, with no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then those who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
May the Lord be on your lips and in your heart, proclaiming the gospel of God at peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with them. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a shout, 'Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him.' Then all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, 'Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out.' But the wise replied, 'No. There will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves.' And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids came also, saying, 'Lord, Lord, open to us.' But he replied, 'Truly I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Please be seated. This morning, as we gather, we will be observing the second Sunday in November. So it's another Sunday of creation. It's also, therefore, a children's sermon Sunday. And children's sermons that we are doing right now are related on the lessons that are in the formation packets. So it has nothing to do with the lessons that are before us, because I want them to think about what's in their formation packets. And the lesson for the formation packets for Christian Ed is the story of Abraham. And the material that they have, most of it focuses on the sacrifice of Isaac. But as much as that story is important to us in our Christian understanding about the offering of an only son, I think that it's better to look at the broader picture of Abraham. We ask them to do that in the material that's before them. Abraham was a man who was called by God to go on a journey. And so really, the story of Abraham is the story of stepping out in faith. Stepping out in faith. Abraham was 75 years old when he was asked by the Lord to step out in faith. 75 years old to start a journey, and God is so helpful, he says, to the land that I will show you. So he asked Abraham to give up his whole community, his old way of being, on a journey to somewhere. Most of us would not get up and go without knowing where we're going. We like to know the destination before we start. So, how can I try to understand this to show this to kids? Most kids will probably never see one of these. Most of the adults here will know exactly what it is. It's a map. I still keep maps in my car. Many of us don't keep maps in the car, but have a map in the car. Have lots of maps in the car, a whole container full of maps. And so the map, of course, most of us know, shows us the roads and the directions, so we can figure out where we're going. Where to turn left, where to turn right, what we're going to see along the way. We're used to living our lives by following a map. I said most kids will not see their parents, could refer to a map. They'll refer to their phone, right? They'll listen to their car. And in some ways, that's a little bit more like Abraham's journey. I don't really use that very much. Once in a while, I'll use it. My wife uses it all the time. And that's a good thing. But, you know, when you're using the directions on the phone, it'll say 3/4 mile and turn right. Okay, right? And then go, and then once you make that, that gives you the next step of the journey. Unless you've looked it up ahead of time or downloaded the map on Google so that you have a written text, you don't know where you're going. You have to step out in faith that the map's going to be right. Sometimes it's not right. The phone's not right. Sometimes something has happened and it has not updated, and you've got to sort of trace back. Luckily, it will give you alternate directions as you go along. When you miss it, don't make a turn at it once, it'll find you another way. But most of the time, we are used to following maps. We have a whole set of directions with our life. We like life that way. Those who use the systems on the car very often are just stepping out on faith, waiting, that trusting that they know what they're doing, they'll get you there. Sometimes it's frustrating when they want to tell you to go one way, and you say, No, that's not the way you go. So you start talking back and say, no, I'm not doing that. Because you know better. You know the community, not the map. The company doesn't know the community and what's happening. So sometimes the posted way on the phone is not the best way, but we step out in faith anyway. So Abraham was asked to step out on a journey, leave everything behind, with his wife, who was old as him, and he was taking his nephew along, and to go, that God would tell him where he was going and where he would stop. There are times in life where we need to follow the map. There are times in life when it's good to know exactly where we're going and so that we can make a plan. And there are other times in life where we just have to step out in faith. May God always give us the grace to know when to follow the map and when to step out in faith. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Will be found on page 4. Let us pray to God, the Lord of the harvest, that he will bring to fruition all that he desires with his creation. Lord of the harvest, when we lift up our eyes to perceive with Christ's eyes, we see that the fields of the world are already white for harvest. We pray for your church that it may be spiritually equipped to reap the harvest of souls.
We pray for Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, for Michael, our primate, for William, our diocesan bishop, for our companion dioceses of Ecuador Central and Ecuador Litoral, the province of Jerusalem in the Middle East, for the diocese on the Anglican cycle of prayer this week. We pray for Trinity Cathedral, for those in the vocational process. We pray for the diocese as it prepares to gather in convention.
Lord of creation,
in your mercy, hear us.
Lord of the harvest, you have created the universe by your eternal word and have blessed humankind in giving us dominion over the earth. We pray for your world, that we may share and conserve its resources and live in reverence for the creation and in harmony with one another.
On this day after the election, we pray for patience and understanding, for peace on our streets, and patience in our hearts as we await the results. We pray for all those in the election process at this time, for those running for public office, for all those who are counting, for those who are maintaining our peace and security, for those working for peace and nuclear disarmament across the globe, for those in the armed forces and diplomatic service at home and abroad, and for their families who watch and wait for their safe return.
Lord of creation,
hear us.
Lord of the harvest, whose Son has promised that the Spirit will lead us into all truth, we pray for the community in which you have set us, for one another and for ourselves, that we may bear the harvest of the Spirit in love and joy and peace.
We pray for those who are victims of abuse, corruption, hunger, hatred, violence, gun violence, for those facing immigration issues, for our many fellow citizens who are unemployed, underemployed, we're on furlough at this time. For those who fight COVID-19, for all doctors and nurses, medical researchers, scientists, first responders, and other essential workers.
Lord of creation,
in your mercy, hear us.
Lord of the harvest, though you have given the human race a rich land, a land of streams and springs, wheat and barley, vines and oil and honey, we have made by sin a world of suffering and sorrow. We pray for those who bear the weight of affliction, that they may come to share the life of wholeness and plenty.
We pray especially for Bev, Megan, Maria, Betsy and Mel, Julie, Cindy, Mark, Oakland, Ursula, Ed, Tracy, Holly, Riley, Calvin, Gail, and Jack. For Marlena, Melissa, Bridget, Gary, Norma, Kathleen, and Charles. For the health and well-being of all those in our country and across the globe who are ill with COVID-19, for those living with prolonged illness, that is preparing for and recovering from surgery, remembering especially Peter and Gina, for those recovering from surgery, for those who are with child, and for all those who mourn and grieve at this time.
Lord of creation,
in your mercy hear us.
Lord of the harvest, your Christ, the first fruits of the resurrection, will put in the sickle for the harvest of the dead at the end of time. We pray for all those who have gone before us in his peace, that he will bring safely home all whom you have given him, and gather us all to share together in the banquet of the age to come.
We pray for all those on the All Saints, All Souls Memorial list as we continue to offer their names in prayer. For Kelly Belmont, Paul Haas, Kevin Jeffrey Collis Priest, and for Millie. For Arlene Wilkinson, remember through the Book of Remembrance.
Lord of creation,
in your mercy hear us.
Almighty God, who has given us this good land for our heritage, we humbly beseech you that we may always prove ourselves a people mindful of your favor and glad to do your will. Bless our land with honorable industry and sound learning and pure manners. Save us from violence, discord, and confusion, from pride, arrogance, and from every evil way. Defend our liberties and fashion into one united people the multitudes brought hither out of many kindreds and tongues. Endue with the spirit of wisdom those to whom in your name we entrust the authority of government, that there may be justice and peace at home, and that through the obedience of your law we may show forth your praise among the nations of the earth. In the time of prosperity, fill our hearts with thankfulness. And in the day of trouble, suffer not our trust in you to fail, all of which we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us confess our sins to God.
God of all mercy,
we confess that we have sinned against you, opposing your will in our lives. We have denied your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created.
We repent of the evil that enslaves us,
the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your will and serve only your will. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Peace.
There are just a few announcements today. Our thanks to those who sponsored Walkers for the Souls for the Harvest. And those proceeds will be forwarded to the diocese and returned back to the parish for the support of the Gleanings Ministry on Tuesday nights. Please note we are coming to the close of the season for gathering Thanksgiving foods. Thanksgiving foods will be taken on the 18th, and they are distributed through Trinity Cathedral. Please remember you should have gotten an e-newsletter earlier in this week and later in this week, and will be available actually on Sunday the 8th. The paper Advent letter, if you're not here on Sunday, it will be mailed to you. It has important information on ordering tickets for Christmas services so that we can meet the limitations that are on us at this time, which is 45 people. We don't want people to show up and find that they get turned away. So we are having them pre-order tickets. So look for that. You can order either electronically or through the site or on paper, and then we will get in touch with event tied right with reserving your spots. When a service reaches 45, that service is closed. Offer to God the sacrifice of thanksgiving and make good your vows to the Most High. Great Thanksgiving begins on page 7. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
All thanks and praise are yours at all times and in all places, our true and loving God. Through Jesus Christ, your eternal word, the wisdom from on high by whom you created all things. You laid the foundation of the world and enclosed the sea when it burst out from the womb. You brought forth all creatures of the earth and gave breath to humankind. Wondrous are you, Holy One of blessing. All you create is a sign of hope for our journey. And so, as the morning stars sing your praises, we join with the heavenly beings in all creation as we shout with joy, Holy,
holy, holy,
holy,
holy Lord,
God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Glory and honor are yours, Creator of all. Your word has never been silent. You called a people to yourself as a light to the nations. You delivered them from bondage and led them to a land of promise. Of your grace, you gave Jesus to be human, to share our life, to proclaim the coming of your holy reign, and to give himself as a fragrant offering. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, you have freed us from sin, brought us into your life, reconciled us to you, and restored us to the glory you intend for us. We thank you that on the night before he died for us, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his friends, and said, Take, eat, this is my body broken for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, said the blessing, gave it to his friends, and said, Drink this, all of you. This cup is the new covenant in my blood poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. And so, remembering all that was done for us, the cross, the tomb, and resurrection and ascension, longing for Christ's coming in glory and presenting to you these gifts your earth has formed and human hands have made, we acclaim you, O Christ.
Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Christ Jesus, come in glory.
Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be to us the body and blood of your Christ. Grant that we, burning with your Spirit's power, may be a people of hope, justice, and love. Giver of life, draw us together in the body of Christ, and in the fullness of time, gather us with the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, James, Matthias, Leo, Martin of Tours, Charles Simeon, Samuel Seabury, and all your people into the joy of our true eternal home. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, our God and Creator, in voices of unending praise.
Blessed are you, now and forever. Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace. Alleluia.
Let us pray for those who are not able to be with us, saying, My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the blessed sacrament of the altar.
I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving.
As I proclaim your resurrection, I love you above all things and long for you in my soul.
Since I cannot receive you in the sacrament of your body and blood,
come spiritually into my heart.
Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me, in this life and the life to come. Amen.
The gift of God for the people of God. body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Let us pray. The first communion prayer will be found on page 12 at the top. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth a people forgiven, healed, and renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen.
The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and always. Amen.
Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.